Hello and welcome to Changzhou in Jiangsu province for semi-finals day at the Adidas China Masters, event number 7 on the 12 tournament OSIM BWF World Superseries. And of course the Superseries is the elite tier of tournaments in the world of badminton. And of course at the end of the year we have the Superseries Finals as well. Well, I'm Jill Clark, and as I say, it is semi-finals day. What a lineup we've got for you, starting with women's singles and the Olympic champion, Xuerui. She's up against Porntip Buranaprasertsuk of Thailand. Their mixed doubles and Yuanun from Korea trying to reach their third consecutive final in 3 tournaments played. They're up against the number 6 seeds from Indonesia. Their men's singles and Sho Sasaki, the left-handed Japanese player, trying to reach his first ever Super Series tournament final. He's up against Sohwan Ho, fresh from his victory last week in Taipei. Then women's doubles and Jang and Kim from Korea up against Ma Jin, who's won mixed doubles for the last 2 years here, playing women's doubles with Tang Jinhua. Then the last of our semi-finals, Jan Jorgensen, the only European left in the tournament on semi-finals day. He's up against Wang Xiaming of China. So what a terrific lineup it is for you. And as you can see, the players have already come onto court for the first of our semi-finals in this afternoon's session. It is the number 1 seed, the Olympic champion, Li Xuerui of China, up against Porntip Buranaprasertsuk of Thailand. Well, the number 1 seed is the best ever she's done at this particular tournament. Last year, fresh from her Olympic victory, she's the number 2 seed here in Changzhou. She lost in the quarterfinal to PB Singh. Buranaprasertsuk, 21 years of age. She'll turn 22 next month. Her opponent is already 22 years of age. Porntip, 18 in the world ranking at the moment, but she has been as high as 8. That was in June 2000. Xuerui, of course, is the current world number 1. And then for a young Thailand player, this her first semi-final appearance for exactly a year. Last time she was in a semi-final was the Japan Open. Event number 8 on the OSIM BWF World Superseries happening next week. It's exactly a year since she was in the semi-final for this year lady. Of course, this is a regular occurrence for Li Xuerui, winner of the Indonesian Superseries premier event earlier this year. And 3 times she's been beaten finalist, including the World Championships recently. Of course, lost to another Thailand player in those World Championship finals. Lost to Arachan. So, our umpire Tanai Teng from Malaysia calls for play to get underway. Xuerui nearest to us. Good opening rally. Oh, that was going wide. This is the 4th meeting between these 2 players. The Thailand coach, Udam Lang Chayapon. There is a little bit of a drift in this lovely arena. Shuttle will fly a little bit faster coming towards us, in other words, coming towards Li Xuerui. Well, I'm saying this is the 4th meeting. Only 2 of their previous 3 encounters have actually been completed. Because in the first round of the Korean Super Series, the very first Super Series event of the year, in the very first round, Li Xuerui retired at 7-all in the first game against Porntip. Oh, service fault called. Our service judge from Denmark, Christian Johannesson, first two meetings. This lady from China won them both, but won them both in three games. So expectations that this should be a close encounter. As we said, I think that Porntip has had a bit of a lean spell in world terms. We've seen that 4 years since she was last in a semi-final. And when you consider that she has been as high as world number eight, that's a little disappointing. Of course, she made history as far as being the first player from Thailand ever to win a women's singles title at a Super Series event. That was the Indian Super Series of 2011, but so much of the spotlight nowadays on Ratchanok Intanon. Perhaps that's just freeing up some of the pressure. This young lady is feeling able to just get on with her badminton now. In the women's singles discipline from Thailand. It's going long as well. And of course, Xuerui, given a walkover in her second round match, supposed to play against Sun Yu of China. So she only had to play two matches to get through to this semi-final stage, whereas of course Porntip has had to play three matches. And this lady from Thailand has disposed of the number seven seed Minatsu Mitani in the second round. Three wonderful games it was too. Tough match yesterday as well for Porntip. Oh, that's a good backhand. Yeah, good attacking play. Certainly in a quarterfinal against Han Li from China. Han Li fresh from her bronze medal at the China National Games. Looked very sharp indeed, but it was two games, but she was so positive. That's what really impressed me about her performance yesterday. Tried to be adventurous, tried to create something out of nothing. Yang Ning, two-time Olympic champion, now on the coaching bench for this lady. Recently returned to coaching Yang Ning after the birth of her daughter. Super shot from Li Xuerui.
9-7.
22-year-old who was born in Chongqing in Sichuan province, just finding a winner from nowhere, just guiding the shuttle across court. Indeed, I guess possibly the tactic and thought process is that because she's playing with the win from that far side of the court, but she didn't hit too many clears, and therefore she feels the need to attack as much as possible. But that, again, is absolutely magnificent.
9-4.
Clear that really did the damage. Yeah, and a little signal there from Chinese player to coaches to ask the question, was it going long? Well, that's certainly gone wide, and it means
11,
that the unseeded Porntip Buranaprasertsuk of Thailand has the advantage at the mid-game interval, albeit just 1 point. But psychologically, makes such a difference as a player to have the lead. There you can see both Xuerui's knees have been strapped. Played a lot of badminton of late. World Championships. Of course, the China National Games have been taking place, and earlier this week, Li Xuerui won the gold medal.
11-10.
Liu Xin in that final. Now we know that Liu Xin is already through to tomorrow's final here at the Adidas China Masters, because earlier today she beat the left-handed Sayaka Takahashi in two straight games. Oh, goodness.
13-10.
Well, I was wondering yesterday, if you were with us, you will have seen Porntip playing against Han Lee. I did ask myself the question as to whether during this last year she's really been adding a new dimension to her game. Points, four straight points has come to an end.
11-13.
I think from what I've seen so far here in Changzhou, I think that's almost certainly the case. She looks a far more aggressive player. More deception as well. What a courageous thing to do. Take time out, work on your game. Know that it may not translate into results straight away. In fact, you might have to take a backward step before you can take two or three steps forward. She really has taken a good couple of steps forward. Of the last 7 points going to the Thailand youngster. Oh, good net shot, but short. Good placement. Aim towards the right shoulder of Porntip. Very, very difficult to defend. It was that net shot that did the damage. Look where Xuerui's feet are. Nowhere near the back of the court. That's why she had the opportunity to play the winning smash. because of Buranaprasertsuk's good attacking play, I think the Olympic champion is a little bit wary of playing to the back of the court, trying to play the perfect net shot, and in doing so, making the error. Oh, that's lovely. Oh, didn't follow it up. A hold and flick from the backhand side at the net from Li Xuerui did the damage.
14.
Did her winning shot hit it wide? Oh, everybody's getting a little bit tense. That's understandable. The business end of the game now.
15-17.
Didn't give the shuttle enough height, didn't get it past the Olympic champion, really invited the straight smash.
16-17.
And now there's just one point in it. Determined to attack as much as possible, and all credit to her for doing so.
18-16.
Very much more difficult physically to keep the attacking play going. And that's what you need to do when you're playing with the drift. And that's gone wide.
19-16.
Well, the 21-year-old from Bangkok is just 2 points away from taking the opening game against the Olympic champion. It's gone wide as well. Goodness me.
24
game point opportunities. 16. Only needed the one. That didn't even reach the net, I don't think. 21-16 and a stunned silence from the crowd here in Changzhou. Well, 15 minutes needed for game number one. And an upset on the cards because Porntip Buranaprasertsuk is a game up against the Olympic champion.
ตรงไล่เส้นหน่อยเพราะว่าเรือตกแรงอยู่แล้วแล้วก็ตก
แล้วขวามันเหมือนจะออกนิดๆครับผมนั่น
Zhang Ning on the left looking a little bit concerned about her player. World number one. Game down against the world number 18.
Second game. Long ball play.
There's no doubt about it. Porntip Buranaprasertsuk of Thailand thoroughly deserved that opening game. Now it's going to be interesting because I think that Xuerui is going to have to start doing hard work and keep the shuttle going down. The more that she's hitting the shuttle down, the less work it has to do. Much, much physically easier to move forward than it is to move backward. That you've played a good net shot, stand your ground at the net, because if your opponent lifts, as I've just said, liable to go long of the back line, and therefore you can stand your ground at the net. Look at that, how she anticipated again. Yep. Doesn't have to worry so much about the back of the court. Of air. And because the shuttle is so light, it does affect the flight of the shuttle, but of course, players nowadays play in these stadiums with the air conditioning on. The air conditioning very low, but it does affect the flight of the shuttle. No question about it. And that in turn affects the style of play that you can use from one end to the other. Idea.
Five, four.
Oh, I remember yesterday, Xuerui in her second game against Guzian from Singapore was 10-17 down in the second game. She'd already won the first, but 10-17 down after one thought and probably going to be treated to a third and deciding game, but she fought her way back.
Five.
You don't get to become Olympic champion in world number one unless you've got good fighting spirit. Jump smash at the start of that rally from Porntip, and there was a gasp, audible gasp from the crowd. We're used to seeing it in men's singles, but I can tell you we're seeing it more and more in women's singles. The game's developed. Yep, that's the problem for Li Xuerui. controlling the lifts to the back of the court. Good judgment. That's just wide and looking straight down that line. I think a bit of a sideways drift as well. From right to left, and I think that shuffle just got carried with the drift slightly. Took it wide. Shot. Oh, indecision. Goodness me. Fabulous play from both players. Was the indecision. Look at that spinning net shot, and yet Porntip still managed to get a good lift off that. And it's interesting, after losing the World Championship final, Li Xuerui spoke in her press conference and said, "We've been thrown down a challenge by some of these players from other countries. And we must respond. We must find a way." Well, from what I've seen in this tournament so far, everybody's responding. Everybody's decided that the game of women's singles, the discipline. To be more athletic, more dynamic, more attacking. And it really has developed into the most wonderful spectacle. Smash into the net, the error from Porntip means that, as with the opening game, it's just 1 point in it at the mid-game interval, and in contrast to the opening game, it's the number one seed, Li Xuerui, who has the advantage. Goodness me, how is that not called a fault? Serve there, was a lovely slow-mo. Racket, of course, must be pointing in a downward direction. Must be struck below the waist. Feet must be stationary. Must strike the cork first. Not allowed a double movement. So many service laws, and that's why we have a dedicated service judge each and every match. His sole responsibility is to look at the serve and make sure everything's legal. So 11 and 10, second game. It's gone wide. Rally. surprising, both players asking for a quick timeout to towel down. That was so important. Yep, the coaches realize it. Just look at their reaction. Similar pattern to the opening game. Four straight points. 9-10 down in the opening game to Porntip, and then here in the second, four straight points from 9-10 down to Xuerui. First game beginning to take its toll. Porntip Buranaprasertsuk. As far as Porntip is concerned. That's superb. Oh my goodness. It's the long. And indeed it was won by Porntip. Ray, been double. Yeah, it's all hard work from that far side of the court. You've got to keep attacking. Winner and didn't move at all. Played a shot and stood where she was. Here in Changzhou, trying to get behind Xuerui. Take a look at this. Plays a shot. That's it. I've had enough of that rally. Perhaps. Just couldn't move. Yeah, that's nice. Well, the crowd are lifting her. And as I said a little earlier, she is a supreme fighter, we know that. Oh, this is really developing into a very, very 16, intriguing battle. Your opponent is struggling physically. There's a couple of rallies ago when Xuerui just didn't even move after she played the round the head shot. One thing you've got to do as an opponent, make sure she has to play the shot. Make sure you get yours over and in. It's not to say you go negative. is struggling. Once again, no power in the legs to push forward. Change direction, she was on the back foot. She was worried about having to go back in court. Look at her feet there. Nothing pushing forward. Yeah, results to the power play. Guts and determination. Great skill too. 2 points now from the second game. Oh, well, help by the net cords. We all need a little bit of luck occasionally. Just asking for the court to be mopped of the perspiration. Herself five game point opportunities. Only needed the one. It is one game all in this women's singles semi-final. Not an excellent match so far. 34 minutes of pulsating badminton. Everything to play for. The third and deciding game. So the players ready for the third and final game. Very obvious that from the first two games, and indeed from the first rally of this deciding game, who's ever on that far side of the court can use the drift as far as their smashes are concerned. My goodness, it is much harder work physically to keep attacking. That rally. Xuerui didn't have to play one single shot from the back of the court. we played four rallies and Li Xuerui has not yet had to play one single shot from the back of the court. From mid-court forward. Li Xuerui has not been forced to play one single shot so far in this deciding game from the back of the court. There we go, that's the first one. Shot. Nice little shot. Just showing why she's reluctant to play Xuerui to the back of the court, because every time she tries to do so and get a good length, it's going to go away and set up a little bit. Six all. Great net shot. Good use of the body smash too. She had the full diagonal of the court to scamper. Look, she plays the round the head shot and yet still is quick enough to play the kill from the front of the court. That is incredible. anything you can do, you can do just as well. Yeah, a little wry smile there from Xuerui. Not quite sure if she was trying to get out of the way of that. In by the drift. Guys, those net shots are just unbelievable. And again. That didn't cover in the end, but just watching that rally, Xuerui just standing very much in the base position until that final shot. Unfortunately, we didn't see him on in the rally, but Porntip was being pushed to the back, brought forward, pushed to the back, brought forward. And because Porntip was so reluctant to play to the back of the court, it was this young lady from Thailand who was doing all the physical work. Guaranteed. In all three games, the mid-game interval, there'll be just one point in it. But whose advantage will it be? Xuerui doesn't like the call. And in fact, talking to the line judge, looking up at the giant screen in the arena here. Look, she's going to have a word with the umpire. In fact, apologises to the umpire. Well, wouldn't mind seeing that again. Immediately on the offensive. Virtually no backswing. Straight. Oh, wow. perhaps that disputed record. He's just fired the Olympic champion in the right direction, using that anger and aggression, challenging it. They think they've been hard done by. Others become even more determined. Four straight points. Thailand. And I think the world needs to take attention to the fact that there's about four or five in singles players from Thailand that will make a real impact in world badminton. The next shot that forced the short lift, should have been deflected by the net cord. Each and every point so precious. This stage of the match. Xuerui. I wasn't expecting this one back, and then just had the calmness and the awareness to just place the shuttle in a downward direction into the open space. Didn't have to be powerful. And look at that, Porntip punching her chest as if to say to herself, come on, use your heart, fight for everything. One game all, 17 all. She's looking up at the giant screen. Second match point opportunity. Umpire having a word with Porntip. And Porntip just turning around to her coach and saying, just watch it, calm down. Upsetting the umpire now. It's going to go long. It is long. And Porntip Buranaprasertsuk on a second match point opportunity has beaten the Olympic champion, the world number one, Xuerui. What a magnificent contest. 22-20 in the deciding game, a match just 3 minutes shy of the hour mark. But it was badminton of the very, very highest quality. She thought about playing it. I always felt it was going long, and look at the reaction from the 21-year-old from Bangkok. She's through to the final with victory, 21-16, 15-21, 22-20 in the deciding game. She's beaten the Olympic champion.